Hi, as you know, I'm Dr. Douglas Jeffrey. This is day three at the ECTRIMS meeting. It's been a very interesting meeting. So far, there have been over 1,000 different scientific presentations presented at this meeting. Many of them are in the form of posters, such as this one, and many of them are oral presentations. Now, of the things that might be of interest to you, one of the very interesting subjects that often comes up is the etiology of MS. So there's a variety of people who think MS is an autoimmune disease, and there's a variety of people who think that MS is probably an infectious disease caused by a viral agent. The fact is, we still don't know. There is one school of thought that says MS is actually an autoimmune disease that's induced by a virus. So today there were a number of presentations on susceptibility to MS and what happens when a patient gets MS. And basically there's general agreement that there's an interaction between genetics, the immune system, and environmental factors. So for example, relapses often follow viral infections, and there's an age-related risk in migration, and that suggests that exposure to some infectious agent could actually be very important in terms of the development of MS. There's also noted MS epidemics in various locations throughout the globe, which would be consistent with the involvement of a transmissible agent. And there are also human demyelinating syndromes that are caused by viruses, although there's a great many viruses that are involved. But for example, measles, HTLV, and JC virus can all cause demyelinating syndromes. So, and there's a number of different mechanisms by which viruses can be involved. One of the most interesting, and one that you'll hear the most about, is the Epstein-Barr virus. And it turns out that basically 100% of adult patients who have MS have been infected with the Epstein-Barr virus. An infection late in childhood is associated with a greater risk of developing MS. And in fact, in children with MS, they also have a much higher rate of Epstein-Barr virus infection compared to those children who don't have MS. Epstein-Barr virus is a very interesting virus, and what it does, it infects a certain type of immune cell known as a B cell and transforms these cells, and then these cells can then reside within the brain without causing active infections. There's also some thought that the immune system may actually become confused and fail to distinguish between parts of the Epstein-Barr virus and parts of myelin, so that it might attack both, and that could be one out of an etiology for MS. So that's a very interesting area of research which is ongoing, and I'm sure you'll hear a lot more about that in the future.